children, welcome to today's class. How are you all? I hope everyone are fine. And are you watching videos every day? I hope so. You are doing and watching the videos every day. So far we have completed our first unit, and in the last session I explained positive, comparative and superlative degrees. And today in this class I am going to share some of the grammar from your textbook, that is unreal past. What is it? Unreal past. In the name only we can say real means it is present, unreal means it is not. And past means in the past, which didn't happen and we feel that it might happen. See this sentence and observe it. I wish there was an air-conditioned coach. I wish there was an air-conditioned coach. From which lesson we have taken this sentence? Just think. I wish there was an air-conditioned coach. So you can remember the first lesson. So in the lesson we said the town mouse and the country mouse, and when the town mouse travels to the country, the town mouse felt very uneasy to travel in the normal coach, because in the normal coach there is no air condition. So while it suffers from the suffocation, then the town mouse says this sentence while traveling in the train. Town mouse says, yes or no? It says, I wish there was an air conditioned coach. But actually, was it there? Was it real? Was it really there, an air conditioned coach? No, it wasn't. So that's what we are saying, these things as unreal past. In the past only it has happened, and there is no air condition in the general bogey. So he said, and it is not real, so we are calling it as unreal past. Okay, by seeing this sentence we understood that it is an unreal past. But if we want to say, if we have gone through one situation like the town mouse, how do we express our unreal past? For example, I saw my friend. She has a remote controller car with her, and I felt they all were playing and I am alone. I wanted to play something. Then I felt, if I have a remote control car, I can also play, I thought. But actually, do I have a remote controller car? No, I don't have. But I am expecting that I should have. Here also, there is no air conditioned coach, but town mouse felt, might it be there? It feels very happy. But it is very, the sentence meaning is, it is feeling very sorry for not having air conditioned coach. So, likewise, in the same way, I am also thinking that I don't have a remote controller car, but I am expecting, I am wishing. That I should have a remote controller car. Now how do you express? If you want to express that kind of things, if you want to express unreal facts, first you need to know how to frame the sentence in that unreal past. This is one of the sentences in unreal past. Now let me see the structure of this sentence. First, you should write wish plus. Why we should write wish? Because those things are not there, but we are wishing, we are expecting that those things should be with us. So obviously, for any unreal past action, if you want to say, you need to use this wish word in your sentence. Start with wish plus subject. About what you want to say, that subject, and then later wish plus subject plus past tense. What you have to say? Past tense. You have to use the subject and past tense. Again, here you need to know. So last night you had dinner. If you want to say today morning, what do you say? Generally, we all know, simply we'll say, I ate dinner or I ate supper last night. What you will say? I ate supper or dinner. Yes or no? You will say in the same way, I ate supper or dinner. What do we follow here? We are following the subject I, and in the past tense, it will change into ate. And what is the remaining part? Supper. So we said I ate supper. Simply we said, this is about past tense. You need to use in this way only. Now I'll say the next one. Before example I have given, I wish to have a remote controller car or else remote car. Then what do? I will see the subject. I wish. Present tense means what we will say? I have a remote controller car. What is the past form of have? What is the past form of have? That is had. So, I have a remote controller car. If we change into past tense, what it becomes? I had a remote controller car. I had a remote controller car. Yes or no? But was it there with us? No. We are saying unreal fact. So you need to keep I wish. I wish I had a remote controller car. You don't have, but you are expecting that you should have a remote controller car. So far I said, again I'm explaining children, just pay attention. First you need to say I wish, because you are wishing. Then whatever you want to say, say in present tense and change the verb. I have a remote controller car. Change the have into past, it becomes I had a remote controller car. I wish I, if I want to say, I wish I learn scooty. I learn driving scooty. Then if I want to say past tense, I wish I learn will change into past tense. What it is? Learn past form. Learn. I wish I learned scooty driving. That's it. This is how you have to change the tenses into unreal past. And I'll give you two more examples here. Let us see what are those examples. Children, I gave two examples here. See those. First one is, Sindhu has missed her school bus. She has to go to school urgently. She wishes to have a car. How would Sindhu express her wish? How would Sindhu express her wish? Means we are not saying about Sindhu. We should feel that we are only Sindhu and how Sindhu says. So how I will say, if I want to say, I have a car, I will say. But in the past tense, we have to change the verb, because the what is the structure? Wish plus subject plus past tense, right? So I wish I had a car is correct. I have a car will change into I had a car. But it is all about our wishes, which is not real. We wish those things to happen. So we should say, I wish I had a car. If I write here, see the answer, I wish I have a car will change into had a car. Here in this example, if you see, we are changing the present verb into past. And we should write always I wish. Now see the second one. Mahendra wants to get first rank in the class, but he cannot. How would Mahendra express his wish? Mahendra wants to get first rank in the class. and he should express that his wishes that he should get first rank. So first we will make sentence in present tense that I get first rank in the class. What is the verb here? Get is a verb. Now change this verb get into past. How it changes? Get will change into got. And we always use I wish in front of the sentence because it is unreal fact and they are wishing those things to be happen. Now see, first as usual, I wish we should write. So I wish. We should not write here Mahendra word first time because they are, we should express his views how he is feeling. Means how Mahendra has to say, we should write that sentence. So I wish I get first rank. Get past for God. I got first rank in the class. Okay children, see, if you don't understand, go through the video again.